Thank you. Thank you, everybody. That was, it was unbelievable. I don't know. I've done comedy for a while. I've done a lot of different shows. They're not, you know, they're not as all exciting as The Tonight Show. I did one in a prison once. Like, in it, like, all the way in it. Like, we went to them. Like, I didn't, like, meet them out, you know. So, we go in. Let's say you guys are the inmates. So, I'm sitting here. I'm, like, doing my dumb jokes. None of it works. Every joke I have involves being outside in the past 30 years. Like, I'm like, traffic's crazy. You guys remember? Who remembers? People remember traffic here, right? So, I'm doing my dumb jokes, and then an inmate gets up and starts walking towards me. I'm like, oh boy, here we go. You know, like he's going to use me to break out. And I don't want to point at him, but no one's like, look at, but I am using hand gestures. I'm like, what do you guys do on this side of the room? Should he be walking up like that? Turns out the bathrooms are behind me. He's a good guy. I judged him on what he was wearing and where we were at. It was my fault. So I'm like against a brick wall, and it's like goes like halfway up, and then the urinals are like all behind here. So then he comes to use the bathroom, and then he comes to the urinal right behind me. So then it's just me and him just looking at everybody, and he peed. He peed without even kind of a, it was the most confidence I've ever seen in my entire life. I thought, whatever you think this guy did it, all right? That's not, an innocent man doesn't pee like that. That's a guilty, I'm not getting out. I took social media off my phone. It's too much. Like, you just, you know, you walk around and just look at it all day. They did, Facebook, they did a good job. It's a real good company. And Facebook's just too much. It's either everybody's best or worst days of their life. You know, like you're either like, I'm getting married or my house is on fire. No one's like, today's normal. Nothing happened. I have no strong opinions about anything. My wife gets mad because she was like, you don't like any of my photos on Facebook. And it's like, is this not enough? Like us just being married and living together. And it's like, you know, how much, and I did like it. When we took it, I said, I liked that photo. Like, I told you that. I'm in the photo. There's not much more than I can do in this photo's life. We've been married for 10 years, and we still fight. Like, you can, when you're married, fighting is open 24 hours. Anytime. We got in a fight recently at 3 a.m. We woke up to get in this fight. And we live in Nashville, and we have a dog that freaks out when it thunders. So it was like thundering. So we have sedatives to give her because there's only so many times you can tell a dog it's just thunder before you're like, just take this. Hope this works. I'm not gonna hold you through it, you know. So I wake up. And I'd asked my wife, I was like, hey, where are the sedatives at? And she was like, they're at the top of the cabinet. So I go get them. When I get them, I looked at the bottle, and the bottle said they were expired. So I had to, like, wake her back up, and I was like, hey, these say they're expired. And she was, like, annoyed. She was like, they're not expired. Those are new pills in an old pill bottle. And I was like, all right, you know, I should have thought of that. That's my fault. I mean, people come to our house all the time and they get milk and they're like, is this milk expired? And I have to go, that's new milk in an old milk jug. Are you the stupidest person I've ever met in my life? How could you not figure that out? That's basically what I told her. It wasn't as fun as that, you know, but that was the gist. And instead of just saying, you're right, that's a logical statement, she dives all in and tells me it doesn't matter because dog medicine can't even expire, which she's never even heard a rumor about that. She doesn't know that. We don't know any dog medicine people. I know who she knows, and we don't know one dog medicine maker that's like testing her, like, let me tell you a little secret about dog medicine. We've invented medicine that can't expire. All right, thank you guys so much. I appreciate it.